Greetings and welcome to Unit 9 of our www.inflateyourmind.com online textbook. In this unit, we're going to talk about income distribution and income inequality. We're going to take a look at the income distribution for the households in the United States. Even though the things that we're going to be talking about in terms of income inequality really apply to pretty much all countries in the world. So if we look at the income distribution for all households in the United States, we noticed that the lowest quintile, the poorest 20% of all income earners in the United States, earn about 3% of all income. By the way, I've rounded all these numbers to whole numbers. The wealthiest 20% earns about 51% of all income earned. The other numbers listed here are the 8% are for the second quintile, the 14% is for the third quintile, and 23% of all income is earned by the fourth quintile. So we can see that there's definitely inequality in the United States. If you compare the lowest quintile, 3%, to the wealthiest quintile, there's quite a bit of difference there, of course. Or you can also look at the combined percentage by the lowest 80%, which is 49%. And if you compare that to the wealthiest 20%, they earn actually 2% more. So on the surface, the differences are relatively big. However, there's a lot more we can say about income inequality than what these numbers will tell us at first glance. So the first thing we can say about income distribution is that these numbers, the incomes earned by these various groups, they're not static. So when we take a snapshot picture of what it is right now this year, these are the numbers that you see, but if you look at a 10-year period of time, for example, we see that there's a lot of income mobility. In fact, we know that of this lowest 20%, about 60% moves into a higher quintile, one of the other quintiles, within about 10 years. Similarly, a significant number of people from the top 20% also move down to the lower quintiles within 10 years. So this mobility means that if you are poor at one point in time, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to stay poor. There are opportunities, especially in free market economies, where people can advance and improve their income over time. Now, we do have 40% of the people within that lowest quintile who do not move up to a higher quintile. So that's a little bit concerning, but there's a couple more things we can say about the income that they earn over time. So the second thing we can say is that the overall amount of income earned by the entire country is not static. 20 years ago, the total amount of income earned in the country might have been only this much. So then if you had 3% of this piece of pie, then you would really not earn a whole lot. But if over time it grows, then you can see that slice actually gets bigger, and then you might have 3% of a bigger slice. So even the 40% of the people who are remaining in the lowest 20%, that's not a good thing, but even they are improving their lot over time. So the pie grows, and that means that the total income earned by even the poorest 20% will increase over time. The other thing we can say is that income distribution numbers don't include non-cash transfer payments, for example, housing subsidies, food stamps, money that people get for medical insurance subsidized by the government. Those are not included, and they can actually add up to quite a bit of money each year. Taxes are also not included, and taxes are mostly paid by the higher quintiles. If we do include non-cash transfer payments and taxes, then we can actually say that the income share of the lowest quintile triples and the income share of the highest quintile falls by 25% according to the latest census statistics. Benefits that people earn on the job are also not included. The total value of all benefits, for example, health insurance benefits that people earn on the job, has actually increased over the past number of decades. So the conclusion that we can draw from these numbers is that the raw statistics, the 51% and the 3% of the income distribution in the United States, don't tell the whole entire story. We can't just say that the wealthiest 20% in the United States earn on average 17 times the amount that the lowest quintile earns. As we saw, these statistics do not include important and valuable job benefits to people, as well as handouts that people get from the government. In addition, 3% in 1980 is not the same as 3% in this year. Usually in a free market economy, because we have income inequality and because we have opportunities for people to advance, there is incentives for people to innovate and to work hard. And that's one of the reasons why the pie grows. So the 3% this year is much bigger than 3% decades ago. And on top of all that, as we said, there's income mobility. Quite a few people move to a higher quintile over time and improve their earnings and improve their overall lot in the economy.